चलें जी, बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम।
दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 2 फॉर ऑटोमोटिव इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कोर्स कोड EE202। एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर नंबर 4। टाइटल ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट्स एंड ओम्स लॉ। Right, so slide number 3 is a definition of circuit. A circuit is a complete path that electrons travel from a power source such as battery through a load such as light bulb and back to the power source. It is called a circuit because the current must start and finish at the same place. So a circuit is a path of electron. These electrons, they start from the power source. This source can be the utility supply or a battery, a lead acid battery or a solar panel. And then this electron, they pass through the load. This load can be a light bulb, it can be a motor. And then when the current passes through the load, the current must return back to the power source. For any electrical circuit to work, it must be continuous from the battery through all the wires and components and back to the battery. And when the current returns back to the battery, it returns back to the battery at another terminal. The current starts from one terminal and it returns at the other terminal. If we are dealing or if we are considering the conventional current, then the current starts from the positive terminal of the battery and returns to the negative terminal of the battery. And if we are dealing or if we are considering the electronic flow, then the electronic current starts from the negative terminal of the battery, passes through the load and returns into the positive terminal of the battery. However, when we consider conventional current, then the negative terminal at which the current returns to the power source, this negative terminal is normally considered as the ground. It is the ground is a potential which is at 0 volts. A circuit that is continuous throughout is said to have continuity. Continuity is the action through which current continuously flows through the circuit. Now in this diagram, what we see is, we see a power source. In this case, the power source is a single dry cell. Then we see connecting wires. These connecting wires, they provide the path for the current. Then there is a control. In this case, it is a very simple on-off switch. And then another connecting wire from the control to the bulb. Now, this bulb is the load over here. The load is the light bulb. It is the place where energy is being converted from electrical to another kind of energy. For example, in this case, we are converting electrical energy into light energy and heat energy. The bulb, it converts electrical energy into light energy and heat energy. Then when the current passes through the load, there is another path which returns the current to the negative terminal of the battery. So this is our one example of the circuit. Next slide. What are the major parts of a circuit? The various parts of the circuit, they include a power source. It is the component that provides the energy. It provides the source of energy. And in vehicles, it is a battery. Normally, it is a battery. In vehicles, it can also be the generator also. So in vehicles, there are two types of sources. One is the battery and second is the alternator or the generator. The generator is a component which converts mechanical power or mechanical rotation into electrical energy. Then second component is the protection. Protection from harmful overloads, that is excessive current flow. And protection devices, they include fuses, circuit breakers, and fusible links are examples of electrical circuit protection devices. Then the third component is the power path. The power path for the current to flow through from the source, from the power source to the resistance. This path from a power source to the load, a light bulb in this example, is usually an insulated copper wire. The copper wire is the power path. The copper wire is insulated. The copper wire is insulated because for one reason, for safety purpose. And the second reason, that two wires, one that is providing current from the power supply, power source to the load, and the second wire that is returning the current from the load to the power supply, should not be in contact. So the copper is insulated by a PVC, polyvinyl chloride material, and it serves the isolation purpose. Fourth is the electrical load. Electrical load or resistance which converts electrical energy into heat, light, or motion. Then we have the fifth component, the return path. The return path is also called the ground because the return path is always at 0 volts. A return path for electrical current from the load back to the source so that there is a complete circuit. This return or ground path is usually the metal body, frame, ground wires, and engine block of the vehicle. Now, this is very important to note, the return path. Let us look at figure 4.1. Figure 4.1 Let us look at figure 4.1. The figure 4.1 shows battery. This is the power source. The current starts from the positive terminal, passes through the fuse, and then into the load, the light bulb. Now we see a separate return path, that is the negative, that starts from the load, and it is a separate wire that is returning the current back to the negative terminal of the battery. So this is one procedure. This is one procedure to return the current to the battery. Now let us look at figure 4.2. This is another technique to return the current to the battery. That is, there is a battery, the positive power terminal, and in between we will have the fuse and then a wire into the load. Now, then we use a small wire and we connect the small wire to the body of the vehicle or the engine or any metallic body that is also connected to the negative battery, negative side of the battery. Normally it is the engine or it is the vehicle body. Then we use one heavy wire that we connect the negative side of the battery directly to the metal body or the engine. So this will also provide the return path, because the metal body or the engine, it is also made up of metal, and metal can allow current to pass easily. Now, what is the advantage of using circuit shown in figure 4.2? What is the advantage? The advantage is that we are using a smaller current path for return purpose. In figure, if we compare with figure 4.1, the return path consists of a separate independent wire connected to the negative part of the battery. So in case we have to troubleshoot, then, or in case we have to connect a new load, then instead of using a long wire, we can use a short wire which will be directly connected to the vehicle body or the engine. What is the advantage of using a smaller wire? What is the advantage of using a smaller wire? There are two advantages. First advantage is that the longer the wire, the larger the resistance of the wire, and therefore more voltage drop across the wire. If we use a longer wire, then due to the resistance of the wire, we will observe a larger voltage drop. Second advantage of using the body as a return path is that we will have less number of wires. Therefore, troubleshooting time will also be less. The circuit will be less complicated. So for this case, in many commercial vehicles, we will find that there is no separate wire, or there are very few separate wires that are serving as the return path. This return conductor, return conductor. There are very small number of wires that are being used as return conductor wire. Most of the loads at one side, they are connected to the positive side of the battery, and at the other side, they are connected directly to the metal body, so that the voltage drop is small and the troubleshooting time and the number of wires is less. It makes the circuit less complicated.
Sir, ye voltage drop wali baat phir se bata denge ek dafa.
Voltage drop wali baat ye hai ke voltage ka formula, the voltage formula is V is equal to I into R. If we are using a wire like this, if we are using a separate wire as shown in the red diagram, then this return path conductor is a wire which has certain resistance. Okay? If we use a separate wire, then there will be resistance. The current flowing through this wire multiplied by the resistance of the wire will cause a voltage drop across the same wire. When there is voltage drop across the wire, then that means that the load is given a smaller voltage. So this is a disadvantage for using separate return conductor wire. Now let us take the case where we are using a small wire and connecting it to the metal body of the vehicle or to the engine. The engine area is large, therefore the resistance of the engine area of the vehicle body is small because resistance formula is resistivity into length divided by cross-sectional area. Since area is large, therefore the resistance presented by the metal body of the vehicle and the engine, the resistance will be small. Hence, voltage drop in case of metal body and engine, the voltage drop will be smaller and the voltage presented to the load will be large. So this is the advantage of using the metal body or the engine block as a return path to the negative side of the battery. Then is the sixth, the switches and the control that turn the circuit on and off. The sixth component of the circuit include the switches and the control. These switches and the control, they will turn on or off the circuit, or they will increase or decrease the voltage being given to the load. For example, when we want to have when we want to have more light from the light bulb, then we can give larger voltage and this will increase the light. Or we can use additional light bulbs in parallel. We can always use additional light bulbs in parallel with the first bulb. This will also increase the light intensity and it will be controlled by a separate control switch. Next slide. The next slide presents circuit faults. What are the circuit faults that are normally found in automotive electronics? The first circuit fault is called the open circuit. An open circuit is any circuit that is not complete or that lacks continuity, such as broken wire, as shown in figure 4.4. For example, one circuit having the following features: no current at all will flow through an open circuit. For example, if we have a broken wire, if we have a broken load, or if we have a broken or fused or open fuse, or if we have corroded connection, any connection that has corroded with time, or if we have loose connection, those connections that are not tightly bound with the source or with the connect control switch, these all open wire or open circuit will cause zero current, or they will cause no current to flow in an open circuit. Right, an open circuit may be created by breaker in the circuit or by a switch that opens, turns off the circuit and prevents the flow of current. Another technique to get open circuit is as shown in figure 4.3, where we are using a separate switch intentionally to turn off the device. Now this switch, it is indeed not a fault. It is a part of the control. When we want to turn off our electric load, then we can always open circuit using a switch. And then the third part is in any circuit containing a power load and ground, an opening anywhere in the circuit will cause the circuit not to work. And this is quite logical, that when we have a broken wire or a broken load or a fused or a blown fused or a corroded connection or a loose connection or even an open switch, then since we are not able to provide power to the load, therefore the load and the circuit, they will not be working, they will not execute. So this is the first type of fault, that is the open circuit fault. Next slide. A light switch in a home and the light head switch in a vehicle are examples of devices that open a circuit to control its operation. ठीक है? And fifth is, a fuse will blow open when the current in the circuit exceeds the fuse rating. This stops the current flow to prevent any harm to the components or wiring as the result of the fault. Now this is very important, that what is the purpose of the fuse? The fuse will prevent excessive current. The fuse will prevent any excessive current to flow into the load, and this will prevent any harm to the components or any harm to the wiring, which are as a result of the fault. When the fuse blows, it will open circuit itself, as shown in the blown fuse diagram, where this small wire, it is shown open circuit. Now, why did this wire become open circuit in a fuse? This wire became open circuit in a fuse because in some past, there must have been large current flowing through the path, and this large current was dangerous for the components, it was dangerous to the vehicle, and to prevent any accident and to prevent any harm, the fuse becomes open, more current flows than its own capacity. As a result, the fuse is blown, and what happens to the circuit? The circuit becomes open circuit and the load becomes off. It becomes off and no power is given to the load. So the disruptor of the fuse is the process of protection. And when we say open circuit, we mean that too much large, extremely high resistance will appear as open circuit. So mathematically, an open circuit is given by infinite ohms. Open circuit is equal to infinite ohms. And how can we say that current is zero? Then we have V is equal to I into R. I can be rearranged, current can be rearranged as voltage divided by R. In case of open circuit, resistance is infinity. Therefore, we have V over infinity, and the result is 0 ampere. Okay, thank you very much.